Hello friends, welcome to Pioneer of Success. We are starting a new course exclusively for research scholars, specially for those scholars who are just stepping into research career. So in research, we need many skills. We need to learn many softwares and also we need to learn other techniques. And in this particular course, we'll be covering all the things that a novice research scholar needs. Starting from plotting softwares like Takeplot, like Origin, citation softwares like EndNote, Mendeley, coding languages like MATLAB, Python, C, C++, and also other softwares like CFD simulation softwares, ANSYS, COMSOL, and so on and so forth. So in this particular course, we'll be covering all the topics. So I guess this course will be helpful for all the research scholars who are just stepping into research career. So today's topic of discussion is citation. Citation is an important part of research, and whenever we do something, we need to follow some background, and to justify that we have followed a particular background, we put some references. So we take data from past work and we put references for the same. Now, initially, we need to learn about a citation, and then we need to know some software that is required to put multiple citations at a time. Suppose you are writing a review paper. In that review paper, there could be more than 500 references. So, tackling 500 references manually is not so easy, or it is not possible, and that is why people prefer reference softwares. So initially I'll be discussing about EndNote. Today I'll not go through the details of the EndNote. In this particular video I'll be talking about citation. So let us go to Google Scholar. You just type Google Scholar, you click on it. Now type any paper. Say I have searched Turkevich method. So this is a method to synthesize gold nanoparticle. I work on it and that's why I have searched it. So let us not go to the details of gold nanoparticle. Let us see when a particular paper, article or book chapter, book appears in Google Scholar. Then multiple things appear with this particular one. See, this is the source PDF website, acs.org. If you click on it, it will go to the ACS. This is the journal website and this is the paper and this is published. You can see this is the journal name, the Journal of Physical Chemistry B. And here you can see the number of citations. That means this paper has been cited 1315 times. You can see the article views. Whatever, my intention was not to go into details of this, but to show you what is a citation. See, let us download this paper so that I can tell you in a better way. Say, if you go to the end of any paper, you see references. Yeah, I'll just enlarge it. Yeah, so this is one reference. So you can see the names of the authors are given initially. Then something metal nano optics in encyclopedia of nanos. Metal nano optics. This is the name of the paper might be. And this is published where? Encyclopedia of Nanoscience and Nanotechnology. Some journal name might be. Let us go to some other one. Yeah, this one. Say this two. This one is the name of the author. Et al. Means multiple authors are there. That's why they put et al. And this is the name of the journal. Proceeding of. That is P. We call it PANAS. Published from USA, and this is the year when it is published, 2003. This might be the volume number. What is volume number? What is page number? I'll come to 8 separately, but for the time being you know this is the volume number and this is the page number. Now let us go to ACS website. Just I write ACS. So this is the website of ACS. Now we have to go to, we have to search different journals. So ACS is a publishing house, American Chemical Society. This is a publishing house and it has several journals like this one, ACS Applied Energy Materials. So we click on it. So it will take us to the website of ACS Energy Materials, Applied Energy Materials. So this is a particular journal of ACS. Now every journal page, if you go, there will be those options like list of issues, current issue, authors, about the journal. About the journal, if you click on it, you can learn about the journal, when the journal started, what is the scope of the journal. Scope of the journal is what type of work it takes basically. So from the name also you can understand this is energy material. So it papers related to energy consumption, energy harvesting, exploiting different materials, and those could be the area of those could be the area which this journal takes. So I was talking about issues. So list of issues. So I click on it. So you can see 2020, it is showing. This is 2021. Let us, yeah. Now you see May 24, 2021. So this is issue 5. This is issue 4. This is issue 3. This is 2021 going. Issue 2, issue 1. So how many issues published in 2021 so far? 5 issues. So let us go to 2020. Then we can understand how many issues it published in 2020. Because 2020 is already over. This has not taken, just a minute. Or we go somewhere. Yeah. This is, you say 2019 has come anyway. So you see this is the issue 12, issue 11 and up to issue 1. So what does it mean? Every month it publishes an issue. Now what is issue? Let us click on it. Suppose this is the 12th issue. Let us click on it. So this is the December issue 2019. Yeah, see, this is volume 2 issue 12. That means under volume 2 this is 12th issue. So this issue number and volume number is very important. I can just show you. Suppose, yeah, this particular paper, you can see ACS Applied Energy Materials published in 2019. So this is 2. I told this is issue 2, sorry, volume 2. You see, this is volume 2. And under this volume, the issue number is 12. Okay. So there would be volume 1 also. As there is volume 2, there would be volume 1 also. If you just go back and see, all these are all belong to volume 2. See, issue 11, volume 2, issue 10, volume 2. So under volume there are 12 issues. So if you go up to 1, yeah, so all are volume 2 issue 1. So likewise there would be volume 1 and under volume 1 there will be 12 issues. And how many issues, it depends on the journal. Say this journal publishes 2 volumes per year per se, and each volume has 12 issues. So there might be other journals who publishes more or less. So it depends on the journal. Now I go back to Google Scholar. So there is something called cited by, and this is cite. If you go there, you'll see something is written cite. Now what I do, I'll just click on this cite and there will be multiple options. Okay, so BibTeX, EndNote. These two I'll be talking about. BibTeX is a file. When we use LaTeX, we'll also talk about LaTeX in some other class. But this BibTeX, this is used for this LaTeX. So if we write a paper in LaTeX, then we need to download this BibTeX file. And EndNote is for Word. If we write our paper in Microsoft Word, then EndNote is a useful tool. Now let us click on EndNote. So one EndNote file .env file will be downloaded, which will bear all the information about this particular paper. Now this is the easiest way to go and download a particular paper. Suppose I want to search a particular paper on Google Scholar. How easy it is, I'll show you. Suppose I want to search this particular paper. I don't know where it is, but if I know the name or DOI, whatever, then I just go, I paste it here and I search it. You see, only a single paper will come. So it becomes very easier to download a citation from Google Scholar. But the same citation can also be downloaded right from the journal website. So this is the same paper. So here it is. I click on the paper itself. So there will be options for downloading. See, this is the, those are the options where you, this is for the Mendeley, this is for the RIS. Download citation. Okay, this is for sharing. Sometimes a journal does not provide all the formats, but if you go to Google Scholar, there we may get the format for EndNote. But what I want to tell you, you can also download those references from this journal. So Mendeley is the recent software to put citations. We'll also talk about it, but I prefer to use EndNote because there are multiple tools available. In Mendeley also has, but EndNote is a tool that has been in use for long years, and that's why I prefer EndNote. But anyway, I'll be talking about both the softwares. Anyway, now I go to Google Scholar. I have downloaded it. If I double click on it, I have already EndNote X9 installed. So if I double click on it, it will go to this EndNote. Where now if I click on it, all the information about the journal is stored here. Sometimes this journal name goes to a wrong place, then you have to just Control C, copy it and put it in the journal place, and you can delete it. Sometimes it comes wrong in EndNote, and you can save the documents. Okay, now this is the information about this particular paper. How many authors? Those are the names of the authors. In which year it is published? It is published in 2006. Title of the paper is Turkevich Method for Gold Nanoparticle, whatever. The journal is this. The volume number is 110. Issue is 32. I have already talked about what a volume and issue are. Pages means each issue has multiple pages and that bears a particular page number. And suppose a paper is 5 page long, so the page number should be say from 105 to 110. Similarly, this particular paper, the page number goes from 15700 to 15707. So it has 7 pages. Okay. So all this information you can get from this EndNote citation file. Sometimes this citation file can also be downloaded in TXT format where similar informations will be given. So we'll be talking about this in detail. So today we only talked about citation, what are the different portions of citation, लाइक आई वॉज टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर पेपर, या दिस पर्टिकुलर पेपर, सो अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग, इनिशियली द नेम्स ऑफ द ऑथर्स आर गिवेन, ऑल आर नेम्स ऑफ द ऑथर्स, दिस इज द केमिकल रिव्यू, दिस इज द नेम ऑफ द जर्नल, नाउ इट इज़ नॉट रिटेन केम रिव्यू, केमिकल रिव्यू, इट इज रिटेन केम डॉट आर ई वी डॉट, सो ऑल द जर्नल्स हैज abbreviated form, this is standard one and governed by the journal itself. So chemical review, they write it as chem dot rev dot. So it was published in 2004. This is the volume number, maybe 104, and this is the starting page number. In some there are different citation styles. We'll be talking about these citation styles in the next class, but today you just know, you just learn that this particular number signifies initial page number of this, for this particular paper, because this paper is belong to a particular issue, it has certain page numbers, but the paper starts from this 3893. It's a kind of book. When we go to index and find some particular location in a book, similarly we go to a journal issue, we look for 3893 page number, there this paper will appear. So this is the fact. So today we are stopping here, and in the next class we'll talk more about reference, different referencing styles, and how to put references via EndNote in a doc file. So till then, bye, and please subscribe to our channel. We are working hard to help you in any form, and we'll be covering all the things that a researcher requires. And that's why those videos will be very much helpful to you. Thank you.